stands humbly in the Alentejo Plain, 90 miles from Lisbon. The village seems to belong to another age, the pattern of life unchanged for generations. Outsiders could find it romantic, simple, primitive, not yet raped by the 20th century. Yet behind the medieval charm of village life, sanctified by the dictators who oppressed Portugal for 50 years, lies a history of permanent, pressing misery. The old men never romance, but remember the past, when they went barefoot in tattered clothes, when they knew hunger and feared starvation. The women bore children to work here and die here, who knew no world beyond the village. For 50 years, these were a forgotten people. They worked as labourers, virtually as serfs, at the mercy of the landlord. They were cheap labour, feeding the nation with cheap food, and the nation liked it that way. The peasants of Portugal were colonised by their own countrymen. In the last 20 years, hundreds of thousands of peasants, seeing no hope in Portugal, left their homes and families to work in Western Europe at jobs no one else would take. But most did not escape. The women suffered most of all. The women of San Miguel don't mind the washhouse, nor the cold, sometimes freezing water. They're used to suffering, just as much as the men. They work all the hours of daylight. They rear poor children, clean poor houses, cook poor food, iron threadbare clothes. They tend the animals and work in the fields. For them, the washhouse is a shared reprieve from the drudgery of the day. For 50 years, São Miguel endured in silence. The village seemed to sleep in tranquility. In fact, it seethed with frustration. When Portugal rose up against the past, São Miguel was ripe for revolution. This is occupied land, land that 6 months ago belonged to the landlord, which is now owned by the state and farmed by the workers. The peasants of São Miguel have seized 18,000 acres, 34 large farms. The occupation of the farms around São Miguel started last May. Like those elsewhere in central and southern Portugal, they were hardly noticed. Yet now a vast acreage of the country has been seized, almost all of it with the authority of the government. The peasants of São Miguel now sow land, not for the landlord, but for themselves. For them, it's the start of a journey out of the past.
Our life before the revolution was to work in order to eat. If we had to go 1 or 2 days without work, we didn't have enough money to eat. My life was just work and slog and nothing else. This was my life, working all day like a donkey for the boss. My boss was a fascist. They all were, and they still are, grabbing everything possible and giving us as little as they could. For them, we had no human value whatsoever. All they did was drag us down as low as they could. They just took all the profits that were achieved with our sweat. They never look after cattle. They never look after animals. They never look after anything at all. And at the end of the year, they put all the profits in their pockets, and away they went.
The events of the last 18 months have passed some by. Jacinto Carlos is nearly 80 and has worked as a day labourer all his life. He is illiterate.
I would have loved to know how to read and write, but I never went to school. I started work at the age of 9, looking after the animals. We had to work for a long time to get enough to buy a pair of shoes. I always went barefoot, and I was only half clothed.
The old man works a small plot of land, does not belong to the cooperative, and is isolated from the turbulence that began on the 25th of April, 1974.
What does he think of the revolution and the change?
Oh, I know nothing about those things.
Does he know what the word revolution means?
No, I know nothing about it.
Does he know what a political party is?
No, I don't know what political parties are.
What does April the 25th mean to him?
I heard there was something because I went to a meeting of the cooperative at the village hall. But that didn't bring me any reward. The only thing I've earned is what I have worked for.
In the olive grove, they sing another song, Avante Camarade, forward comrades towards the revolution. Until last year, the peasants used to work in gangs for the landlord by day, and by night, silently, they came here to steal for themselves. Now they pick the fruit for their cooperative to sell. Until last year, the peasants worked from dawn till dusk for £1 a day. If they were sick, or it rained, or the landlord didn't need them, they had no work, no pay. Now they get £3 a day and a 6-day week. But it is more than money that makes these peasants happy. They believe they're working for Portugal. By taking more land into cultivation and by working harder, they hope to produce more food for all their countrymen. It's a responsibility they welcome and of which they are proud.
We have a lot of friends from other cooperatives who have come and gave a hand because we are working wholeheartedly and with the greatest pleasure. And we are working for our own cooperative, for ourselves, for everybody.
How I work happily. I'm working for myself, for the benefit of everyone and not for the exploited.
In the past, you know, we worked for the boss and we were put into teams of 10 or 12 women. And we always had an overseer with us, and obviously we were not too happy because he was the boss, the money grabber. He was the master and we were completely subjugated. Now we are working for our own good. We are much freer, therefore we work harder. From today onwards, we shall work harder and therefore produce more for the benefit of all. In other words, as the saying goes, work harder and work better. If we manage to produce more for the country, I think that it will be for the benefit of us all.
Yet even within the cooperative, there are those who feared the landlords but fear the revolution more. In the fields where they dared not speak to each other openly because of informers among them, they're now free to reflect on their misgivings.
Of course we were being exploited, but we are not being less exploited now than we were before. Quite the contrary. At that time we had our wages regularly on Saturday, and now we don't get them. After all, we are working during the day to eat at night. And when we get to Saturday, there's no money to get the food.
I'm now finding myself facing many more difficult problems. I see no profitable result for me of the convulsion which is now taking place. The only thing I see is my life sinking deeper into trouble. We open our mouths, give our honest opinion to a comrade, and there is no respect whatsoever on his part for our own opinions, whatever they might be.
If the critics are ignored, at least they can criticize. And even they welcome the knowledge that for the moment at least, they control their own lives. Portugal echoes to the sound of revolutionary rhetoric. But in these quiet fields, the peasants have taken action, creating the most radical change that the nation has witnessed since the overthrow of the dictatorship. The future of the cooperatives will test Portugal's desire to create not just democracy, but socialism. And that battle will be fought here.